Assalamu alaikum my dear students, welcome to your chemistry class of standard 10. Today I will discuss about chemistry of alkenes. Alkene, alkene is a homologous series of unsaturated open chain organic compound which contains at least one carbon-carbon double bond in its carbon chain. That means in the carbon chain of an organic compound, if there is present at least one carbon-carbon double bond, there may be present more than one, but if there is present at least one carbon-carbon double bond, then that organic compound is called alkene member. Follow the structural formula. This is the structure of organic compound. Follow here. This is the carbon chain. This black chain is carbon chain, and follow here. Here there is present carbon-carbon double bond. That means inside these two carbon atoms there is present double bond. So this is the alkene compound. Now we will know about the characteristics of alkene. The general formula of alkene is CnH2n. It contains mainly carbon and hydrogen atom, but in case of substituted alkene, another atom may be present there. Of this class, carbon 2 to carbon 4 compounds are gases. That means ethene, propene and butene, these four are gases, and from pentene to up to carbon 15 compounds are in liquid state, exist in liquid state, and carbon 16 and onwards compounds are exist in solid state. Mainly alkenes are used in polymer industry for the production of different polymeric products. That means this is the uses of alkene compounds, and we will know about this polymeric products in this chapter in next classes. And they are highly reactive due to the presence of weak pi bond. Here we have known from the previous class of alkene, the alkenes are known as paraffin. That means they has the less tendency to reaction because they have a strong carbon-carbon single covalent bond, isn't it? But here we can see alkenes are highly reactive. Why? Because there is present weak pi bond. What is weak pi bond? Here we know that alkene means there must present double bond, isn't it? My dear students, always remember that the first bond, that means single bond, is all bonds are covalent bond. Here these two bonds are also covalent bond, but first bond or carbon-carbon single, all single bonds are strong covalent bond, and the another bond, that means after formation the one bond, if there is formed another bond, for example here second bond, this bond is called pi bond and this is weak bond. It easily breaks down and takes part in reaction due to heat or pressure or any other presence of any other factors such as catalyst, etc. So, and if there is present triple bond, which we will see in case of alkyne, so first bond will be sigma bond and this is very strong, but other second and third bond, then these are will be pi bond. And we will know about this sigma bond formation and pi bond formation in higher class, that is in standard 11. Just here you have to know single, all single bonds are known as sigma bond, and they are very strong covalent bond. They are not easily breakdown, but another second or third bond, these are known as pi bond, and these pi bonds are generally very weak bond, and these bonds are easily breakdown. And breaking down these bonds, actually these compounds takes part in reaction. Just up to this you have to know in this stage that means in standard 10. But in when you will go next class, that is in standard 11, then you will be more clear about this sigma bond formation and pi bond formation. No need to know now in this standard 10. Now we will learn about the naming of alkene. Alkene, in case of naming, we will follow some rules. At first, numbering the longest carbon chain containing carbon-carbon double bond, so that the double bond gets the possible lowest carbon number. That means you have to consider the longest carbon chain which must contain carbon-carbon double bond, and you have to numbering from that side, in which side this double bond gets the lower carbon number. That means in lowest number of carbon, this double bond is started from the end. If two carbon-carbon double bonds are present in a chain and their positions are same from both ends, then if substitution present, we will get priority. That means if two carbon bonds are present in a longest carbon chain and their position is distance is same from both ends, then in that cases, if in any side substitution started or more substitution takes place, in that cases from that side numbering will be started. In the name, the position of carbon-carbon double bond will be mentioned. That means in naming, you have to mention in which number of carbon this double bond is present, and other rules like as alkene. So let's practice the naming of alkene, then it will be more clear to you. Follow this. Here, this is an alkene compound. Follow here. This is the longest carbon chain. You have to consider this. Follow here. There are three carbons. 1, 2, 3. Also, in this side, there are three carbons. But you have to take this longest chain because there is present double bond. So, this methyl group will be substituted here. So, numbering should be started from this side because here in number one carbon, this is actually this double bond is present between these two carbon. So which carbon comes first, that will be number one. So this is number 1, 2, 3. For this, its name is 2-methyl. In second carbon, there is present methyl radical 2-methyl-1-propene. Follow here. One is the position of double bond. In number one number carbon, there is present double bond for this one, and there are three carbon in the longest chain for this prop, and this is alkene member for the presence of double bond for this in. So 2-methyl-1-propene, or you can write this name like this way, both are correct. 2-methyl-prop-1-in. 2-methyl-prop-1-in. Prop, this is the word root for the number of carbon, 3, and the 1 is the position of double bond, and in is for alkene member. So 2-methyl-prop-1-in or 2-methyl-1-propene, both are correct. Now another example, follow here. This is the longest carbon chain. Numbering should be started from here because double bond is present in from this side in one carbon, number one carbon, and but from this side 1, 2, 3 in number 3 carbon. So numbering should be started from this side. So 1, 2, 3. So in 3 number carbon, there are 2 substitution. 2 methyl radicals are present. For this, its name will be 3-3-dimethyl-1-butene. For 4 carbon of chain, for this 1-butene, or you can write like this way, 3-3-dimethyl-but-1-in. But-1-in. Now follow the another example. There is the, this is the longest chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So our longest chain is of 8 carbons, so this is octene, and numbering should be started from this side because 1, 2, 3, 4. In 4 number carbon, double bond is present, and from this side 1, 2, 3, 4. From here also 4 number carbon double bond is present. So from which side numbering should be started? And now we have to observe the substitution. From this side in second carbon, substitution is started, and from this side, and from this side 1, 2, 3 number carbon substitution is started, but more substitution will get the more priority. So here from third carbon there is more substitution takes place, into substitution takes place for this, from this side number should be started. So 1 2 3, so 3 3 3 6 3 4 5 6 trimethyl, 1 2 3 4 5 6. Actually this name is not correct here, you have to clear again. I am clearing the rules. Follow here, numbering should be started from this side, because follow here, when the double bond position from the both end is same, in that cases we have to follow the substitution. So here from this side in second carbon substitution is started. For this we have to numbering started from this side. Yes, if there is two substitution in this side in second carbon, in that cases we will numbering the chain from this side, because in that cases we will give the priority for more substitution. But here in second carbon substitution started, and here in third carbon substitution started. For this numbering should be started from left side. In that cases its name will be 2 3 4 5 6 2 6 6 trimethyl 2 6 6 trimethyl oct 4 in. Its name will be, I have written also here wrong, but there will be 2 6 6 trimethyl oct 4 in, oct 4 in, 2 6 6 trimethyl. Now follow more examples. Follow here, these are both are butene, but for the position of double bond their name is changed. Follow here, in this example number 1 carbon double bond is present. For this its name is 1-butene or but-1-in, and here in second carbon double bond is present. For this its name is 2-butene or but-2-in. Now this is the hexene compound, and here in second carbon from this side double bond is present. For this its name is 2-hexene or hex-2-in. And follow here, if we consider this is we can't consider this is the longest chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is the longest chain of 8 carbons, but we can't consider this because there is not present double bond. But for this we have to consider this is the longest chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have to take this is the longest chain. We have to consider this, and numbering should be started from this side. So in that cases its name will be 1 to 2nd carbon there is present propyl radical. Propyl radical, for this 2-propyl-1-hexene or 2-propyl-hex-1-in. Now follow the more examples. This is I have said this is butene 1. Here in second carbon double bond is present, in third carbon double bond in present. So from this side number should be started. So its name will be 2-methyl-pent-2-in, or here in second carbon double bond is present, in second carbon double bond is present. In that cases substitution will be get priority. So from this side numbering should be started. So in this case its name will be 2-methyl-2-4-diene, 2-methyl-hex-2-4-diene or 2-3-4, 1-2-3-4-5-6, 2-methyl-2-4, this is the 4 number carbon, 2-4-hex-2-4-diene, not 5. So here diene, because there is present 2 double bonds. For this its name will be, this is also wrong, its name will be 2-methyl-2-4-hex-2-4-diene, 2-methyl-hex-2-4-diene or 2-methyl-2-4-hexadiene. Follow here, this is the longest carbon chain, and in second carbon first carbon double bond is present. So its name will be 1-2-2-ethyl-pent-1-in, 2-ethyl-pent-1-in. So like this way actually you have to name the alkene compounded. I hope it is clear to you, and you will write the name of any alkene compound. Now we will know about the general methods of alkene preparation. That means we will know about the preparation process of alkene. Alkene may be prepared in different ways, but here I have shown in three ways. First of all, alkene preparation from acidic dehydration. Follow here. In this reaction, alkene is produced from alcohol in presence of dehydrating agent like sulfuric acid or alumina or thorium dioxide by elimination of water molecule. Here the number of carbon will be same in both reactant and product. That means here we will produce alkene from alcohol. Follow here, this is ethanol, CH3CH2OH. This is ethanol, and if there is used concentrated sulfuric acid, here sulfuric acid is a dehydrating agent. Dehydrating agent means the substance which actually removes water from a compound. Dehydrating, dehydrate, remove water. So for the presence of this sulfuric acid from alcohol, water molecule will be removed and there is produced alkene. So for this is known as acidic dehydration. That means dehydration occurs in presence of acid. Also we can use here aluminium oxide or thorium dioxide. These are also dehydrating agent. So dehydrating agent, the act of dehydrating agent is what? To remove water from a compound. For this is known as dehydration or dehydrating agent. They are called dehydrating agent. And when water molecule is removed from alcohol, then there is produced what? Alkene. And in that cases, the number of carbon will be same in reactant and product. Follow here ethanol of 2 carbon. So product in product also ethene will produced of 2 carbon. Or alkene will produced of 2 carbon. That means if there is present propanol or butanol, so in that cases there will be produced propene or butene. Now follow another process. Preparation of alkenes from alkyl halide. Alkyl halide. Halide means halogen. Halogen groups are what elements? Chlorine, bromine and iodine. So follow here, this is CH3CH2X. That means if you use here chlorine, so its name will be ethyl chloride. If you use here bromine, then its name will be ethyl bromide. If there is present iodine, then its name will be ethyl iodide, like this way. And here in this reaction, when alkyl halide is heated with alcoholic solution of sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, then alkene is produced with water molecule and sodium halide or potassium halide by elimination of hydrohalide molecule. Here the number of carbon will also be same in both reactor and product. That means when alcoholic solution is used and heat this mixture, then from this compound which are eliminated from this water molecule and sodium halide or potassium halide. If you use potassium hydroxide, in that cases there will be potassium halide. If there is used chlorine, so ethyl chloride when reacts with potassium hydroxide, then there is produced what? Ethene, CH2 double bond CH2, ethene plus potassium chloride plus water, like this way. And if you use here propyl chloride or propyl bromide, in that case there will be produced propene, potassium bromide plus water, like this way. Now follow here another preparation process from alkyne. You know that alkyne means there is present triple bond. So when this alkyne reacts with hydrogen in presence of palladium catalyst mixed with calcium carbonate or barium sulfate, which reduces the catalytic power of palladium by poisoning it, here the number of carbon will be same in both. So here if you reacts butane with hydrogen, then there will produce butene. Just here you have to write butane. From butane we will get butene reacting with the hydrogen gas, or propane. From propane we will get propane. From ethane we will get ethene, like this way. Now we will know about the reactions of alkene. Previously I have said that alkene is highly reactive because there is present weak pi bond. So For this, alkene shows different types of reaction. For example, addition reaction with hydrogen. Alkene generally combines with hydrogen in presence of nickel catalyst at 150 degree centigrade temperature and produce what? Ethane. How? Here double bond is broken down and these two hydrogen atoms are actually enters into this carbon atom and there is formed what? Single organic compound, single bond organic compound, that is ethane. From ethane combines with hydrogen, produce what? Ethane. Now another addition reaction, that is reaction with water. Follow here. When alkene reacts with water in presence of phosphoric acid at 300 degree centigrade temperature and 60 atmospheric pressure, then there is produced what? Ethanol. Here water double bond is broken down and from this water one hydrogen atom is combined with this carbon atom and formed CH3 and another OH part is combines with this carbon atom and produce what? Ethanol, CH3CH2OH. So from ethene there will produce ethanol, from propene there will produce propanol, from pentene there will produce pentanol, like this way. Now another reaction is polymerization reaction. This is very very important and you will learn more about this reaction in this chapter in next classes. Just here you have to know what is polymerization reaction. Polymerization reaction means the reaction in which many small number small molecule many small molecules combine together due to heat and pressure and presence of catalyst and produce a large molecule, and this is known as polymolecule. So this is known as polymerization reaction. That means like a chain, imagine the chain which you used in your thought. Follow here. This chain, how it is prepared? At first the small circles are prepared and these small circles are joining together, form a big chain, isn't it? So polymerization reaction like this here, many small molecules combine together and form a large molecule. This is known as polymerization reaction. Follow here. This is ethylene, CH2 double bond CH2, ethylene, and N means innumerable number. Innumerable number of ethylene molecules combine together and this double bond is broken down and this repeat and repeat. Here innumerable number of ethylene molecule actually combine together and form what? Polyethylene. Poly means bohu, many, polyethylene. So like this way actually polyethylene bag, polyethylene actually prepared. Follow here. This ethylene molecule, that means the reactant molecule, is known as monomer and the product molecule is known as polymer. Follow here. Here many ethylene molecules actually reaction like this. So ethylene molecules double bond is broken down and converted into single bond and they combine together like this way. And this is the structure formula of polyethene or polyethylene. Here ethylene is monomer, polyethylene is actually polyethylene or polyethylene is polymer, and this is the repeating unit which unit is repeated more and more and converted into big molecule, product big molecule. So we say this is the ethylene monomer structure, this is the polyethylene polymer structure product, and this is the actually repeating unit. Here this unit is repeated and form a large molecule, that is product polyethylene. So this is the actually polymerization reaction or important reaction of alkene, and the basis of this polymerization reaction, polymer industry is formed. Now we will know about more reactions of alkene, but they are especially known as identification reactions of alkene. That means you know that alkenes are unsaturated compounds, so you have to identify unsaturation of an organic compound by using these two reactions. How? At first you have to know what is unsaturation. The special properties due to the presence of pi bond in carbon chain is called unsaturation property, and when any organic compound contains double bond or triple bond, then that is called unsaturated compound. So how can you identify the concentration of an organic compound? By using these two tests, bromine water test and Baer's potassium permanganate solution test. So these two reactions are also reaction of alkene, but these two reactions is specifically used for identification of unsaturation test or alkene compound. Follow here, this is bromine water test. Bromine water test means actually bromine, you know that bromine is a liquid, and when bromine is dissolved in carbon tetrachloride, its color is dark red brown color. So if we take two sample and in two test tube, and in one test tube there is present double bond compound, that is alkene compound, and in another test tube there is present another sample which contains no double bond in their carbon chain. So if we add in these two test tubes bromine water solution, then we will see the double bond containing organic sample, it vanish the red brown color of bromine. That means the brown color of bromine remains apparent in the absence of a double bond. That means here in this test tube there is present the sample which contains doesn't contain any double bond. For this, when we will add bromine water solution, red colored bromine water solution, we will see the red color bromine water solution remain unchanged. But when we will add red color bromine water solution in this test tube which contains double bonded carbon, then we will see the red color solution is disappears. So this proves actually this solution is unsaturated compound, solution of unsaturated compound, and this is the solution of saturated compound. Why the color of bromine water disappears? Follow here. Ethylene reacts with bromine and produce what? 1,2-dibromoethane. That means this double bond is broken down and these two bromine atoms insert in these two carbon atoms and form the different product, single bond product 1,2-dibromoethane. For this, the double bond is broken down. For this, the color of bromine is also disappear and converted into colorless 1,2-dibromoethane. So this reaction, ethylene alkene with bromine, this reaction is specifically used to identify the unsaturation test. Now follow another test, potassium permanganate test. Also, the color of potassium permanganate is purple. So when the potassium permanganate color is used in a sample of double bond, and in that cases we will see potassium permanganate reacts with implies the presence of a double bond, double bonded carbon, and manganese dioxide. That means brown color precipitate will form of manganese dioxide. But if the sample is not contain a double bond, in that cases potassium permanganate is not decolorized, it will remain same. So like this way also we can identify the presence of unsaturation in organic compound. And the equation of this potassium permanganate test is like this way. When alkene reacts with potassium permanganate, this is potassium permanganate, and there is produced what? Ethylene glycol. This is known as ethylene glycol and manganese dioxide and also potassium hydroxide or sodium hydroxide. So like this way actually we will identify the potassium permanganate test, identify the unsaturation of an organic compound. This is also known as Baer test. Now my dear students, today up to this, and I hope you are become clear about the alkene, and you will be more and 100% clear when you will read book thoroughly. So today up to this, goodbye, and next class I will come back with alkyne inshallah. So up to that, best of luck.